So many people ask me, well, Pete, what's your tech setup when you're on the road? What tools do you actually use to get things moving inside the truck? And it's actually pretty damn simple setup. And so you already seen, I've got a little iPad Air there, which just sits on a little tripod. And I use that either for notes when I'm doing live streams, or I use it for my meetings, which I'm doing right now. Next up, I have my laptop, which happens to be a Google Pixelbook. Now, this is one of the Pixelbooks which was not available on the Australian market. I actually purchased this from the States, had it shipped out to Australia, but we have the new Pixelbook Go available in stock. So if you're interested in that, head along to itgenius.com and ask our team for a quotation. But that's my preferred laptop, and I absolutely love Chromebooks. Heaps of other videos on our channel on why Chromebooks are a great choice for you. And you can see here that that's my basic setup, and whether I'm presenting at a conference or if I'm just working day to day, that's pretty much all I need. And if I need to drive from place to place, when I shut the lid on my laptop, the little rubber feet actually keep it stuck to the table, so I don't even have to pack it away anywhere. I just literally leave it here. Thankfully, the truck's pretty slow, so it doesn't slide off the table when I go around corners too fast. Now, internet connectivity is the next big one that is super important to get right. And for that, I use a Netgear Nighthawk. Now, I've got the old one, which is called an M1. There is a newer version called the M2, which I would recommend. It's got a few new features, and I don't think you can buy the older ones anymore. But this little modem is a couple of $100, and you just put a 4G SIM card in there. Now, what I would recommend is if you're an Australian customer and you are on the Telstra network, that's the best network to get the most broadest coverage across Australia. You can actually set up a business account and you can set up shared SIM card data pooling. What that means is if you've got multiple phones in your family or if you've got multiple phones in your business, you can actually have all of the data pooled together. And so you're not, you know, going over the Nighthawk when you've still got data available on your phone plan. So that kind of puts everything together. Now, from time to time, depending on how many live streams I'm doing on the course of a month, or if I'm shooting some video and I want to upload it to my team for them to actually edit that video, well, what can actually happen is sometimes I'll get close to reaching my data cap. And right now, I think I've got about 400 or 500 gigabytes a month. Now, most people don't need that much. Most people could probably get away with 50 or 100 gigabytes if you were working full time. But I spend a lot of time on video meetings. Pretty much all my time is on video meetings. Number two, I do a lot of media and a lot of live streams. And so I'm often uploading content. Sometimes it's 4K video content. Sometimes it's live streams that can go for an hour or more. And so what that means is that I've got a heavier data consumption than most people would. Now, those who are interested to know how I actually do these live streams, I've got a digital camera, and that basically plugs into this little device here, which is called an ATEM Mini Pro. And this is by Blackmagic Design. This is a great little device because this basically takes the feed out of my camera, and from that I just plug in a network cable into the little Nighthawk, and then that basically broadcasts the signal. And from there, I would just make sure that I'm in a good spot for my reception, and then I can go to town there, which is nice and easy. Can do my live streams from anywhere I am. Apart from that, that's pretty much all I need. I use my phone from time to time, but I try not to use my phone too much for work. I like to use a computer and iPad for work and put the phone away because, as you know, they can be very distracting devices. Now, a couple of essential apps that I want to share with you that are in my toolkit for my CEO on the road. My essential travel apps are, I've got three recommendations for you. Number one is called WikiCamps Australia. And this is basically what I use to pick out campsites. I can find free camping sites with this. I can find paid camping sites. There's ratings. There's dump points when I need to empty the toilet because there's a cassette toilet you got to pull out and actually dump out from here. And so I can find all of those on the WikiCamps app. And that one also works offline as well. So you can save these offline if you're in a place that doesn't have much reception. My next recommendation is a great little app called Aus Phone Towers. And what this one does is it actually shows me exactly where the phone towers are. So I know that if I have an important meeting or an important call and I do not want to have any issues with internet connectivity, then I can literally drive up to a phone tower and park underneath it. And for each phone tower, it's going to let you know which operators are on there, whether it's Optus or whether it's Telstra, at least here in Australia. And from there, it's actually going to let me know how far away they are, how much bandwidth there are on them. And so I will know before I even get to a town what kind of services are going to be available there. And it's going to help me not have to guess where I'm getting good signal. I can literally go and drive to a place with good signal, and then I'm good to go. Now, finally, and this one is a little bit more for those who want to adventure off the beaten track, this is called Maps.me, which is my choice for off-roading and forward driving maps. And so this service allows me to download offline maps. It's a bit like Google Maps for the off-road, and it gives me things like the topography of different terrain, so I can see how steep different climbs might be. I can also see things like directions, even when I'm off-road or if I don't have signal for any of the Google directions. So they're my recommendations for the top apps on running things remotely as a business owner. Thank you so much for joining this presentation. If you have not already investigated our growth roadmap, head along to our YouTube channel where there are playlists for each stage of business that you are at. So whether you're a launch business, a startup business, a growth business, a scale business, or if you're off to the moon in accelerate mode, we have videos designated and designed for each stage of business that you're at. And really the aim here with our growth roadmap is to make sure that you don't miss anything important along the different stages of business growth. When you're a two-person business, you don't need to have business dashboards with KPIs on a TV up on the wall. But if you're a 20-person business and you haven't got password security sorted out with an application like LastPass, then you're gonna be in trouble. And so go through our different videos on the growth roadmap and learn what things you need to tick off at the different stages. And of course, if you're interested in some help from our team, we'll be very happy to help out with that as well. Speaking about help from our team, we have an amazing free offer for existing customers of Google Workspace, even if you signed up through a web host or through Google directly, and that is our transfer in offer. Now we give you access to a Google Classroom with professionally recorded videos all about Google Workspace. And not only do you get access to that, but you also get access to our Remote Work Playbook, which was an 8-video webinar series last year going open book on how we grew and scaled our business into a remote company over the course of 6 years and how we've been able to remain successful doing that. Now, inside that library, included in those videos is a set of quizzes so that you can actually train your team on how to use all the best features of Google Workspace. And those Google Workspace videos are going to help your team become competent on everything to do with the Google world. And so how to get the best out of Gmail, how to get their inbox down to zero each day, how you can structure your Google Drive permissions correctly so you get everything set up and safe and secure so you don't ever lose any data, how someone can get the most out of Google Calendar and share their calendars properly, create team calendars, and get everyone humming along nicely. All of these are included as soon as you transfer in your licenses to IT Genius. Now, what does that entail? You don't pay any extra for your Google licenses. You just put your billing through us. We're a wholesaler of Google Workspace, and so we pay Google directly, and we can give you the same price that Google gives you, but we can give you a bunch more goodies. And it doesn't stop you from getting free support from Google if you still want to get access to the Google Help Desk, but you do get some limited free support from our own professional support team and access to a few of our other tools. If you're interested in that, head along on the link below this video, or you can head straight along to itgenius.com/transfer. If you need help from our team, jump along to our chat here and our team will be willing to assist with anything that you need. Right now, we're available primarily in Australian business hours, although we have extended hours available for European customers, and we'll soon be adding US time zones as well. So look out for those in the future. If you're not yet on our mailing list, head along to our website and download one of our ebooks. You'll get access to any future announcements that we make on the email list. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.